that she has physical signs of that she is about to give a birth. Would that still be a point at which she could request an abortion?
My bill would allow that, yes.
If a mother is in labor, I can tell you exactly what would happen. The infant would be delivered. The infant would be kept comfortable. The infant would be resuscitated if that's what the mother and the family desired. And then a discussion would ensue.
Where the mother and the physician can decide whether to kill the infant or not. What do you think of that?
Look, Tucker, I understand that you want to go back to a time where Roe v. Wade was illegal.
Democratic politicians have essentially endorsed infanticide, but the media is pretending that's just business as usual, and it's the conservatives who disagree who are radical. I'm Anders Hagstrom, and these are the facts. Do you remember safe, legal, and rare?
Safe, legal, and rare.
That was the abortion mantra of Clinton-era Democrats. But now, they celebrate abortion and propose laws that would allow mothers to kill their children hours before they're born.
She has physical signs of that she is about to give a birth. Would that still be a point at which she could request an abortion if she was so certified?
My bill would allow that, yes.
Two Virginia Democrats endorsed that on video. But what does the rest of the party think? New York Democrats already passed that bill and cheered as they did. But what about on the federal level? They won't say. The Daily Caller News Foundation's Henry Rogers asked more than 10 Democratic senators for their thoughts on the Virginia abortion bill. They all said they hadn't heard anything about it, despite hours of media coverage. Make no mistake, a full-throated endorsement of late-term abortion is radical. But that isn't how much of the media treated it. The Washington Post framed it as Republicans pouncing on liberals for talking points. And this is how the media allows the left to redefine what is mainstream. Democrats used to want abortions to be safe, legal, and rare. But now, when they propose bills that would allow infanticide,
the infant would be resuscitated if that's what the mother and the family desired,
the Washington Post treats it like it's business as usual. You see, it's the pro-lifers who pounce and seize on these policies who are the real radicals. And now let's go to some of your comments from last week's video about the former Starbucks CEO who might run for president as an independent. Mabel Jones says, he don't even know how to make a good cup of coffee. Okay. Hate on Starbucks all you want. Their coffee is not bad. Back me up, Katrina.
It's all right.
Their coffee is totally acceptable. Name a better coffee chain.
Dunkin' Donuts.
Dunkin' Donuts doesn't have anything on Starbucks.
That's wrong.
Dunkin' Donuts is garbage. Dunkin' Donuts is garbage. Starbucks is better. Endorse Starbucks. Not politically, but I endorse Starbucks' coffee. Barbara Olz. Why do I pick people with the craziest last names?
I don't know. Anders Hagstrom.
Hagstrom isn't that weird. It's you say
Anders
it phonetically.
Hagstrom
it it sounds exactly how it looks, as opposed to Olzewski. I'm sorry, Barbara. She says I see free coffee for everyone. That would be a winning campaign pitch. Like for me, I don't know. Just be like. Democrats always run on just, oh, free healthcare, free yada, 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 yada. Republicans are always just like, oh, cut the deficit. I would totally back a guy who's just like, look, I'll buy you a cup of coffee every morning.
Whose dime is he buying you on, Honors?
Your dime. If he makes you buy me coffee every morning, I am totally electing him president. Barry Mottram says, I'm pretty sure he's a rhino. Actually, he's not a rhino. He was never Republican. He's voted Democrat, like, every election for his entire life, and he's donated to a bunch of Democrats. He definitely leans left, but he's running as an independent because he thinks the Democrats have gotten way too radical, yada, 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 and he's like, universal healthcare is a bad idea. So he's that sort of Democrat, but he also super against Trump's wall, super pro leftist policies when it comes to immigration and that sort of thing. Definitely not a rhino, because he was never a Republican, even in name. So he can't be a Republican in name only. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and share this video if you liked it and you want to share it. And also be sure to like this page here at the DCNF Presents the Facts and our friends over at American Voices and the Daily Caller. And if you're watching on Facebook, you can like my page in the description. Thanks for watching.